Everyone, it's me, Jenny, and I'm back for another Not Naked Naked Truth, where Trisha Hershberger chooses a topic and we talk about it as candidly and as truthfully as possible, straight out the shower, messy hair, no makeup. Some people do it naked, most people do it naked. I choose not to. I just usually wear my PJs. Today is a Harry Potter top, which, there we go, Harry Potter. Yeah, and I'm, as always, incredibly wet because my hair is wet. And yes, I will be talking about Trisha Hershberger's topic for this week, which is booth babes. And it was a subject that I wasn't going to talk about this week because I didn't really know how to access the subject. And that's because I've never really been to a large enough convention, which is so industrialized and economized that it has the, you know, they need someone to attract people to a product. I've never been to a convention that's that large. I only go to one a year. So it's not, I've never really met a booth babe. I've never really seen the traditional booth babe. You know, it's just something that I've never really done. And so I didn't really know how to branch this subject without discussing issues which get you lynched off the internet. And so I wasn't going to talk about it. And then I ended up watching a documentary, which is A Movie Club Strikes Back movie pick. Which I'll upload my review for that tomorrow. I Am Santa Claus, which is about the people who play Santa Claus throughout the Christmas period and what they do during the rest of the year. And that drew a lot of parallels for me and really kind of opened up the subject to something that I could actually talk about, which is the idea of respecting people no matter what their career or no matter what aspect of their career they're in. There are many different types of booth babes. The term booth babe is, as Trisha said, incredibly small for what it covers. Booth babe implies female, it implies attractiveness over intellect, or over what the main job is, which is customer service. And anyone who does any sort of customer service job knows that standing on your feet all day, talking to people, being on point and on the ball and, you know, happy all day is incredibly hard and exhausting, especially if you're talking about a convention, which is, you know, many, many days of standing up, talking to many, many people, especially if you've got to do script learning or fact knowledge learning. So you've got to really retain knowledge and then spew it out in a very charismatic way in order to try and get people in. And that's what you're paid to do. And that's why I thought about Santas this way, because everyone knows as a child, you go and see a Santa and it's a Santa. But once you get to an adult, you have to kind of look at people in a complex way. And, you know, being a Santa is a really kind of tough job because you've got to be good with kids, and kids are difficult. Children are very difficult to manage. You've got to be happy and jolly and, again, script learning. And, you know, it's a stressful time of year. These parents are high-wired. They pay a lot of money. You've got to do a good show. And that's, again, it's very, very similar things. So trying to understand people and understand how tough each job is. There's, of course, there's many different levels to a booth babe. It's not gender specific. I think obviously the hardest type and the one that I have probably the most respect for are the salespeople, the ones that actually have to maintain and retain knowledge and then spew it out very quickly, who are there not necessarily for their looks, but they're literally for their intellect. They're there to, you know, talk about the product and have to learn very, very quickly about that product, and do public speaking and that sort of thing. I suppose that's one I have the most respect for. That's not to say that I don't have respect for people who have to, you know, customer service all day and get people in and be charismatic, or respect for the models who are maybe only hired for their physical ability, but then they have to be, again, happy and on point all day and wear heels all day, which is something that I've never had to do, thank God, unless it's by choice, and wear very uncomfortable outfits. And, you know, feel in a way that they are there just to be for their looks. Some of them might not feel like that, some of them may just love it, but understanding that each aspect of the job is, at least on some level, difficult. You're not just there for appealing people in many ways, you are physically working all the time. I think if I were to go into this career, if I were to consider it as a career option, which in a way I have, I'll go into that and that in a moment. area that I'd have most respect for is people who, for example, do cosplay and they love the source material, they adore it, they work really hard physically to get into shape, they work on their sewing skills and their creative skills to make these amazing, amazing costumes, and then they go to these conventions and basically stalk these companies to say, I love your company, you're so amazing, I love you so much, I love my character, and they play the character and they get into it and it's acting and creating and physically draining, and they chase after these companies and the companies say, wow, we respect that, you love our work and we love your work, please represent us. And of course the most memorable example of that was the girl who made the Elizabeth from BioShock costume from First Principles, I think only from the promo art, I don't think the game had even come out, and she had this stunning cosplay and she had the right look and the right face shape and became the face of the brand, and that I have so much respect for and I'm very, very jealous of. And if you're able to follow your passions to such a level and get paid for it, that is amazing, and that is something that I truly, truly respect, and that level of booth babe I love. So when you go to, you know, an Assassin's Creed thing and you have someone in a full Assassin's cosplay who is representing that company, that is something that I immensely respect. And when I say that I possibly considered doing a job in this, fact learning was always very useful and very, it came easy to me when I was in school, it's been a while, but I if I really challenged myself, I think I could do it. Fact learning, script learning, and I love doing costume work. So one of the jobs I actually considered doing when I was 18 to 20, I never really looked into it in too much detail because it wasn't really that good an option in terms of my location. I couldn't really find any jobs that covered it. But costume tour guiding. It sounds very silly, but it appealed to my skill set at the time, and I would like to do something similar maybe one day, because I love being in costume, I love being in character. Script learning has always come very naturally to me, and customer service is just something that I've done since I was 16. I just had my 16th birthday and I started working as a till person, and it's just something that with my drama stuff I can talk to people. I've said it before, I'll just ramble on into nothingness because I am so scared of getting awkward and fumbly that I'll just talk. And I can do, I'm meeting a person for the first time, I'm on this side of a counter, they're on that side, what do you need, what do you need, blah, 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 blah. And script learning, it's something that I always used to be very good at. So I have possibly considered into going into something like costume door guiding where I have information to relay, and I can relay it in a character or in a costume, in a creative way of relaying information in a customer service environment. And that is something that I have genuinely considered, and it looks really, really fun. And to people who actually can do that job, booth babe or costume tour guiding or Santa Claus, I genuinely respect that, and that's amazing. Generally, the term booth babe is just something that I don't respect. The term booth babe I don't respect. People who are in that job and doing that job and keeping up the customer service level and the all of the skill sets that are involved in that, I have huge amounts of respect for. And I think it's just a shame that there's so much stereotyping around it. And it's such a gender unequal opportunity, and looks in an unequal opportunity. I understand that you're selling a brand, but I feel like at some point there needs to be a level of just letting people be people. But yeah, I think it's a career that I perhaps need to do more research into, but those are my thoughts as of the moment. I think if I ever were to go into some sort of booth babe environment, I'd be very happy to do fact learning or customer service or anything like that. I think my only problem would be is if I got told, yes, you've got the skill sets, you've got the basic gist of things, but in order for you to get this job, you need to wear this tiny, tiny, tiny little outfit all day. And it's okay if this happens to you and this happens to you. You have to take pictures as well, and I would say no. But that's just how I perceive the world. I think if anyone feels uncomfortable, and if anyone's forcing anyone to be wearing a certain thing that they're not comfortable with, if I chose to wear a cosplay, and then, you know, the company said, I love it, that's perfect. If I chose to wear a sexy cosplay and they say, that's brilliant, please wear that, then I'm over the moon. If they tell me that I have to wear something on their behalf and I'm not comfortable with that thing that I'm wearing or that thing that I'm saying, that's when I wouldn't want that job. And I rambled on for over 10 minutes, so I'm going to shut up. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. Yeah, I think I maybe possibly said something useful. I'm sorry, Trisha, this video is so long. I'm sorry to, I know you're very busy, but here we go. I'm going to stop talking. See you guys soon. Feel free to comment down below. I've got to go right now. Okay, bye guys.